This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis back with you as it's Bears football here to begin quarter number two. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. They'll indeed go for it with Cutler. It's caught, Eddie Royal. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Second down, 9 yards to go. On second down, here's Cutler. Pass incomplete. He was looking for Jordan Howard that time. And now it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. From the shotgun, Cutler. He rifles one that's intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
When a team's turned it over three times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. Two interceptions, one caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
First down, here's a run with Peterson. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice gain. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Second down following the run. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the five and keep it moving.
Offside, defense.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. First and 10, Bradford. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver. And now it's second down.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Second down now after the incompletion. One receiver left, three to the right. A second down throw for Bradford. And out of bounds right around the 20. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
It's third down, 6 yards to go for the offense. On third down, Bradford, a dump down to McKinnon. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. Call it a gain of five, and that's going to make it fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And Forbath will put this one through, and that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
Here's Thompson on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Marching back out there, ready for the next possession. Here comes the Vikings defense. And the interception the last time, their third takeaway of the game, Charles.
They're just flocking to the football so well. And not only are they doing that, they're making big-time plays and taking it away from them. Big hits, big plays. They're looking very good in this ball game.
You said flocking, flying to the football. Coaches always use that, don't they?
They really do. It's almost as it goes back to the old, when they click off the frame at the end of a play, they want to see all 11 defensive guys in that picture.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Throwing the slant pattern here, complete. 11 yards on the pickup, and that leads to a Chicago first down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
They go play action here on first down. Completion left side to Miller. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Howard receives it from Cutler. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They isolate Jeffrey to the left side. Now Cutler to throw on 2nd down. And Miller with it over the middle. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Give to Howard. And able to work his way down to the 16. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on 2nd and short.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Just 2 yards to go here on 2nd down for the offense. On 2nd down, here's Cutler. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Jordan Howard, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Bears draw a bit closer. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Yeah, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get it downfield for the touchdown.
And that'll make it 13-7. So that drives 6 plays, 75 yards. And the end result is a Bears touchdown. After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And out now come the Vikings. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
They come out here in the eye. Here's Peterson. And some room to roam now. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
I thought guys that were over 30 weren't supposed to run the football this well in the National Football League. How about that veteran leadership? A big-time run combined with some nice blocking by his offensive line. Showing that the ins and outs of being a veteran still has his place in this league. His odometer is not totally turned over yet.
Ready, blue 45, blue 45. Peterson. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Well, he was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
They'll try to throw now. Bradford over the middle here to Rudolph. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Third down and three. Short yardage, Bradford. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
Here's Jeff Locke now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Second and 10. It's Cutler again. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well, and every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
They fake the give to carry. Now Cutler, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Eddie Royal is intended target, and fourth down coming up. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and that just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Three. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Now Cutler going to look deep for Wilson. He's got a man complete. A big connection on that one, 35 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They'll throw on first down with Cutler. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Everson Griffin in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
Second down, Langford, and he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. He'll get three, but it leaves him with a big hole here on third and very long.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football, but these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And that is incomplete. Cameron Meredith, the intended target, and it's fourth down.
The goal of anyone running a curl route is to make sure you try and get defenders on your back and shield them away from the football. But sometimes, even when you run a good route, the defense finds a way to knock it away.
And no move to get Cutler off the field. He stays out there, and they're going to go for it. Here we go on fourth down with Cutler. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Boy, a real head-scratcher there. And it'll be a turnover on downs. Well, that, my friend, I guess is the definition of a head-scratcher. Fourth and long, this stage of the game, what were they doing?
I just have to believe that he looked at the situation, still in the first half, decided if there was a time to be aggressive, now was it, because there's still time to make up for it if things don't go right. Of course, a lot of questions on this one, and look, I want to go for it as much as anyone.
But fourth and long?
Yeah, I don't think I would have there. That one seemed a little bit on the irrational side.
Fans might be a little angry at that one. Bradford. And that'll be incomplete. Cordarrelle Patterson, the one he was hoping to get it to. And it's third down. So now a third and 12 with an extra defender here in the secondary. A nickel look. On third down, Bradford, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. They overload him that time with a safety blitz, and he winds up being dropped for a loss of seven. These strong safeties, some people may not realize it, it's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in him on that play emerged.
Here's Jeff Locke now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Taken in at the 11. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Bears take over. The Bears offense now heading back out onto the field. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try, but they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Now Cutler to throw on second down. And he whips that one incomplete there. And the Vikings with an extra defender in the secondary on third.
Playing coverage here.
And he's going to be brought down. Back at his his own 6-yard line. They were trying to set up that screen, trying to get that screen to formulate. Took too long.
Ends up taking a sack, and that leads you to a couple of other questions. Number one, why don't you just get rid of the football near the screen, guys, so that you don't take an interception? But really, the big one, they just took everything away, and he was really kind of flummoxed on that play and ended up taking the sack.
We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And it'll be Viking football here as they take possession. And now out comes Minnesota. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result. Because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter, you're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him, sat there waiting for him and made the play.
So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. Second down, Bradford. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Just a 1-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be third and 10.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So still a full 10 yards to go here for the offense on third down. Play action now, Bradford. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. It's Tracy Porter with a pick, and he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot, and if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there, and sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Onto the field now come the Bears. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. This is Howard. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
On second down, here's Cutler. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. Chicago! Alshon Jeffrey, 45 yards. And the Bears can grab the lead with the extra point. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. And when they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone. Barthon for the extra point. And he's able to put it through. Well, it wasn't a one-play drive, but I think they'll take it. The scoring summary, 2 plays and into the end zone. After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So the D-line's going to spread out. Throwing, Bradford. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Soldier Field following this short break. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Larry Ridley in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. It's a five receiver set. Three to the left, two to the right. Now a second down throw for Bradford. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And quickly, they get to the line. First down, Bradford. And Rudolph has it left side. A gain of 6 there on first.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think they were looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. Size, the hands.
Speed. Can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Bradford, quick hitter here. It's complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. On third and one, here's Bradford. And he's able to find Diggs. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. And they're going to speed things up here. Bradford on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jarrell Freeman not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. Second down, Bradford out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jarek McKinnon. It's a gain of just 3, and the offense likely going to yield to the punting unit here on fourth down.
But once again, a good example of situational football. That was third and very long, so you know they're regarding it.
Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Here's Jeff Locke now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. So possession goes over here on the punt, and possession will change here with very little time remaining until halftime. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll throw on first down with Cutler. Going for the deep ball. And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. So that is 3 interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action.
Thanks, Brandon. And welcome.